In this video, I'm going to go over how to find the least common denominator of algebraic fractions. These will be a little bit more advanced, where we've got three different fractions. And so we're just stepping up the pace a little bit. Remember, we use LCD as a little abbreviation for least common denominator. And the LCD is simply the least common multiple of the denominators. So what we're doing is focusing on the denominators. The reason we want to find the LCD is because it's in preparation for adding fractions. When we have different denominators, we need to figure out how to get a common denominator in order to add the fractions. So for numbers, I went over several ways of getting the least common multiple. This is on my videos on fractions, so if you want to know how to do it for numbers, look there. Let's say you had 5 over 9 x to the 4th y and 7 over 15 x y cubed and 8 over, let's say, 10 x squared y to the 4th. Okay, and I want to know what the least common multiple of the denominators is. One way of doing this is simply write everything in prime factorization form, including the numbers. So if I did that, and I'm also going to use exponents when necessary. So for instance, this one becomes 3 squared x to the 4th times a y. This one becomes 3 times 5 times x times y cubed. And this one becomes 2 times 5 times x squared times y to the 4th. So this method I'm going to show you for getting the least common multiple is to write everything in prime factor form. But if there's the same factor more than once, then write it using exponents. Now what we're going to do is look at the different types of factors. For instance, 2 is a different factor than 3, x is a different factor than y. And just write them all down multiplied together. So there's a 2. There's a 3, there's an x, and there's a y. There are no other different kinds of factors. So this is going to be the least common multiple of the denominators. And what you do is you choose the exponent. Oops, I forgot a 5. Just forgot that 5. So there we go. We've got a 2, a 3, a 5, an x, and a y. Then you see if any of these have exponents, you choose the highest exponent. All right, there's only one place where there's a 2 and there's no exponents. There's two places where there's a 3 and there's a 3 squared. So you need to have a 3 squared. Then you look for the 5. There's no exponents on any of the 5s. For the x's, the highest exponent would be this one, x to the 4th. And for the y's, the highest exponent is the 4th. And so there is the least common denominator of these three fractions. So basically, this was the least common multiple of these three denominators. Okay, so that's one way of doing it. You simply write the prime factorization using exponents if you've got a factor more than once. Let's do another one. So here's another problem. What we need to do is factor the denominator. So we're looking for the least common denominator of all three rational expressions or fractions. So for the first one, the way to factor 5x plus 10 is to take out a 5. That's the greatest common factor. Now, for 75, notice I have not got this written in prime factored form. So you could use a factor tree or anything you want to write that. But see, I think of that as 3 times 25, so I have a 3 times a 5 squared, and I have an x squared. And for the last one, I have a difference of 2 squares, so that's x plus 2 times x minus 2. Alright, so what we've done is prime factored all of them. Now we have to look for the different kinds of factors. So I'm going to write the least common denominator. I kind of use it interchangeably in a way. I'm now thinking of the least common denominator of these three fractions. So what are the different kinds of factors? Well, I have like a 5, right? I've got a 3. I've got an x. So first I look for the single, monomial type factors. And then I have also an x plus 2, and I have an x minus 2. All right, so for the 5, you can see anywhere there's a 5, you pick any that have the highest exponent. That'll be a 5 squared from right here, right? You're going to choose that 5 squared. Okay, for the 3, there's only one 3, and so that's just a 3. For the x, there's only one place where there's an x, right here, right? And also that has a 2 on it, so the x squared. All right, x plus 2, there aren't any exponents on x plus 2, and x minus 2, no exponents. So altogether, this is your least common denominator. Now, I usually multiply the numbers back out, so that's 25 times 3, 75x squared. And you could either write x plus 2 times x minus 2 or x squared minus 4. It depends how you want to finish writing it. Now, as far as the numbers go, once you factor, if you left this as 75 instead of 3 times 5 squared, for the numbers, you could figure out the numerical part, the 75, some other way as well without doing this prime factorization. I'm just doing all of them the same exact way. All right, here's another example. And keep in mind, on all of these, I'm not paying attention at all to the numerator. All I'm trying to decide is what the least common denominator of the three algebraic fractions are. And you might, usually you only have two that you might be adding together. That would be even easier. All right, so all we're doing is factoring the denominators. Okay? All right, so for this first one, x squared plus 6x plus 9, hopefully you recognize that that is a perfect square. If you don't, you might do it the long way and get x plus 3 times x plus 3, but using this method I've shown you, we want to write that with the exponent, so it's x plus 3 squared. All right, next one. We take out the greatest common factor, so that will be 5x to the 4th, right? And that gives you x plus 3. And the last one, we've got 10x. Now, I could leave that as 10x, or I could write that as 2 times 5x. All right, so now we're going to look at the different kinds of factors. Well, I've got an x plus 3. And I have a 5 as a factor. I have an x as a factor. Let's see, and I have a 2 as a factor, and I think those are the different types of factors, so I'm not looking at any of the exponents yet. Now, I look back up and I take the highest exponent that appears on any of these. So for x plus 3, 2 is the one, whatever denominator has the highest exponent. 5, there's none that have any exponents on that, which means, of course, that's an exponent of 1. For an x, I've got an x to the 4th over here and an x, so I want the x to the 4th, highest exponent. And for 2, there's only one of them, and it's 2 to the 1st power. So it's usually easier to write this as 10x to the 4th, x plus 3 squared. Now these are harder than most problems that you're going to encounter when you're adding fractions, but this is how you could get the least common denominator. And keep in mind that if I did leave this as 10x, you could just decide the least common denominator of 5 and 10 is just 10, right? So you might not have done it in the factored form. So you could either write that as 2 times 5 times x, right? Or you could write that as just 10x. All right, let's do one more. So we're going to start off by factoring each. This is a 3 times x plus 8. Second one, denominator, is a difference of 2 squares, x plus 8 times x minus 8. And the third one, you could take out a common factor of 9, which is an x plus 8. All right, so let's see what we have here for the least common denominator. We are looking for, well, let's see. What kind of factors do I have? How about if we just look at the number ones, you know, just the coefficients. I have a 3 and a 9. You could write that 9 as 3 squared. Notice I left it as 9. But what's the least common multiple of 3 and 9? Hopefully you know that's just 9, which you would have also gotten if you'd written this as 3 squared, right? Because you would take the highest exponent, 3 squared. And let's see. I have an x plus 8. And If you look throughout all of them, there's no exponent on any of them having x plus 8. And the other kind of factor is x minus 8. So that's actually the answer to this one, because again, x minus 8 doesn't have an exponent. Now, you can leave your answer like that, or you can multiply it out by writing 9 times x squared minus 64, and then if you want, you could also multiply that out by 9. So there's different ways of writing the least common multiple. Right, so these are some problems we've done, getting the least common multiple of the denominators for three fractions, algebraic fractions.